I guess this is where I say goodbye. Going to make my blonde coffee from Starbucks. We'll see how it tastes. I think it's gonna be good.
I was like, I'm the one that saw it in the consignment shop.
It's not about me having name brand, it's not me having this, it's me having class.
So it's the guy with his nipple hanging out.
Brady, today's the last day of Vlogmas. Are you sad? I'm just getting out of the shower and check out this little number that I found in my closet. I thought it'd be nice and snuggly. I've actually been waiting to wear this because when Brady was a baby, he would just like jump at my clothes and bite them and tear them. So, you know, I have a few dresses that have like snags at the very bottom because he would just jump and grab. And you know how the little baby teeth are? They're like needles. So he just kind of ruined a few of my clothes. What's that? Is that your toy? I am so happy with my mirror, but I'm looking at this border. I didn't mind it yesterday, but now that I'm looking at it, I think I'm gonna go back and try and paint that. Oh, I took off my nail polish, by the way, because I'm ready for a new color, and I trimmed my nails. This is Royal Rebel. It's like a really pretty dark violet. Do you guys notice anything different? Anything at all? I took the plant out of the corner because I've been meaning to get curtains right here for the longest time, but this little one, I've just been waiting for him to get older because I've always been afraid he's going to bite the curtains and tear them off the wall. So now I feel like he's at an age where I can get some nice curtains there. But anyway, the lights on the tree burnt out. And they did that before. I've had like 3 different sets of lights on there, and they all burnt out, which is fine. I don't think they're meant to last that long. Anyway, I moved the plant over here, and I've had the plant there for before, and I kind of like it, but maybe I'm gonna have to move those mirrors over, or maybe I'll move it into that corner. Just so it balances things out, because I feel as though it's like everything's kind of gravitating toward that wall and it's a little bit off balance. So I don't know. It looks a little squished too. I literally just moved it, so I'm gonna have to like fluff it up. but maybe it might work better if I put it over here. I feel like it balances it out much better. Yeah. I've been meaning to get a different pot for that, and every time I go into Home Goods, I look for something that kind of goes with my home decor because it is, as you can see, a zebra print pot, which is totally random. I was totally into zebra print at the time when I purchased that. Brady seems to enjoy the zebra print though, so maybe I'll just keep it. I just know already that when I start walking in here, I'm gonna see through my peripheral vision that there's this huge shadow right there, and I'm gonna think that there's a serial killer every time I walk into my kitchen. Let's go outside. Sit. Sit. I always make him sit before. Okay, sit. It definitely feels a lot hotter than 90 degrees. Ooh. Ready, go pee. Go pee. Even though it is Labor Day weekend, I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet and go to the grocery store, even though I'm a monkey. I just need to go to the Walmart, fight the crowds, and get some stuff. Plus, I'm gonna be making something kind of special tonight. Not really that special, but new to me.
I was watching Alicia Vlogs. I need to get in the shade. You know, X-Sparkage. And her brother made this really amazing looking dish from fitmencooks.com. It's some kind of cooking website where it's like high protein stuff for people who are trying to watch their diet and, you know, like healthy stuff. So anyway, he made this turkey bacon macaroni and cheese sort of dish, and it looked amazing. So I'm going to go get the ingredients. I'm going to make that for Eminem tonight. So he's just getting out of the gym. He's going to be at my house in an hour. So I need to go and get all the ingredients. I'm looking around at the parking lot, and it's not full at all. It actually kind of looks like a typical weekday. I never come on the weekends, but I also never run out of food on the weekends. So, yeah, I mean, I don't know if you can see behind me, but it's not that bad. Watch me walking in. There's, like, crowds of people. It's actually not too bad here. I'm pleasantly surprised. Check this out. Toasted almond. Alright, I can go for that. What else? I kind of like that blonde coffee actually this morning. That wasn't too bad. Oh, this one is actually really good. It's a perfect and medium roast. I'll show you what I usually get. This guy down here. I'll go with this. Alright, I'm done. Okay, so to all you Breaking Bad fans, I don't know if you guys saw this on the nationalreport.net, but it's this article about Vince Gilligan announcing a Breaking Bad season 6 that begins to shoot January 2015. And I'm thinking, I wonder if that's fake. And some of you have actually sent this link to me, and I'm like, the first time I read it, I was like, oh my God. And then some people in the comments of this particular article said, oh, it'd be nice if it were real. And so I got to thinking, oh, maybe it's not real. So anyway, I'll just read it to you. It says, basically it says, Walter White is not dead. And there's going to be a 6th season of Breaking Bad. We've kept it under wraps for months. Now the cat is out of the bag. Season 6 is coming. It's going to be epic and true to the fans that have followed the show so incessantly. I just couldn't walk away from it. It isn't a cash grab or a sophomoric attempt to bastardize what was such a beautiful ending to season 5. I invested so much of myself in these characters that I had always taken an inkling to return it, even outside the Better Call Saul spinoff. The kicker was I needed a spark, something that made sense for these stories to continue. So I don't know. I mean, I love the show. Breaking Bad is one of my favorite shows, but I'm not sure I would love to see it come back. I just feel like it was such a good ending and it was such a good storyline that I feel it might be best just to keep it that way and end it on a good note. But on the other hand, I'm like, I want more Breaking Bad. So let me know if you are a Breaking Bad fan. Let me know if you are like, I hope the story is true. They need to bring it back. Or do you feel as though it was a great show, but it was great where they ended up? I ended up changing into some leggings, but the issue with these is that they are like totally see-through. So I don't wear these to the gym, I just wear them at home. So they're exercise leggings, but not like public, outside in the public appropriate exercise. So this is what I'm making right now. So I'm boiling the water, and then it says to have quinoa macaroni pasta or whole wheat pasta. So Em and Em are trying, and I are trying to figure out how much. We're thinking half a box.
Let's try it.
Okay. Calls for 4 slices of turkey bacon, but we're gonna do way more than that. So we have the pasta drained, and then over here we have Brady and the turkey bacon and garlic paste. So this is the first time that Eminem ever saw anything like this little cooking protector thing. I put it right here because, especially with bacon, it just like splatters all over you and it hurts. So he's like, what is that? So it protects the stove as well from, you know, food splattering and all that. It hurts to cook bacon, and thus helps me from not being in pain. So it calls for 1 3/4 cup of Greek yogurt. So I'm going to put that in, and then also some mozzarella. It calls for 1/2 cup, but we're cheese people. We need more cheese. So I just put in the Greek yogurt, and it's supposed to get really creamy. Okay, so this is how it turned out. I added so much cheese because the bitter taste from the Greek yogurt was just not the business. So I tasted some of it, and I don't really like it, but we're going to plate this dish. Okay, let's see what he thinks.
That's good.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Let's
you see. Like it.
It's actually not that bad.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We just met Tyrese and the whole gang.
Not her. Did Herschel? Or it's too late now?
I don't know. I don't even know if they even thought about chopping off her arm.
None of them are doctors, so how would they save it?
That's true.
It's gonna happen, Brady. You know.
Brady, what's going to happen? You've seen all the Walking Dead episodes. You know what happens. We are like halfway through. What are we on? Season 3?
Yeah, season 3.
Season 3. He's getting so close. Some of you have been asking me if I'm caught up, and I am caught up to, I guess, current day Walking Dead, but Mystery Man still needs to catch up. Andrea. I cannot stand Andrea. And the governor, oh no. Brady is knocked out. And I think we're on episode 9, maybe? So anyway, just want to wish you guys good night. Good night.
Good night.
And good night from Rick and Lori. So, I guess this is where I say goodbye. Today is the morning of September 1st, so technically I'm kind of cheating with Vlogist because it's no longer Vlogist. And I've been kind of like dreading this moment. I feel like I have just kind of gotten really close to you guys, and I want to let you guys know how much I appreciate you and how much I value this new relationship that I formed with you guys. And how special that is to me. I'm just speaking from the heart. It's probably going to be all over the place. My thoughts and whatever comes out of my mouth is just going to be all over the place. But this is just me speaking from the heart. And I just want to let you guys know that I really do value the friendship and the connection that we've established over this month. And I remember when I first started Vlogist, I was so scared because I just thought, my life is so boring. They're not going to find anything in what I do interesting. And I was just so concerned with being entertaining to you guys. And after like day 2, maybe, I was just like, I can't be entertaining. This is just my life. This is who I am. My life is very simple. And this is who I am. So I just kind of like laid it all out there. There was nothing fake. There was nothing fabricated about the vlogs. It was just me living my life, took my camera with me and just filmed it. And I just want to thank you guys for being so welcoming to me and Brady and to my family. Here, Brady's right down here, so you guys can say what's up to him. I just want to thank you guys so much for being so kind to us and my family and my friends and everybody who was a part of Vlogist and a part, not just a part of Vlogist, but a part of my life. Thank you for being so kind to everybody in my life. And you guys are a part of my life. And I just want to thank you guys for allowing me to bring you into my life and be a part of my everyday life. this is me. This is my life. Just like, you know, with the Vlogus intro, this is my life. And I just want to, I'm just going to keep repeating myself. Like, I thank you guys so much for just being there and being so welcoming and so funny and being so kind to me. I don't really know what else to say, but it was really, truly an honor to do this and go along on this journey with you guys. So, with that said, I don't want to stop vlogging, and I don't want to wait another month until I see you guys. So, I decided I'm not going to do daily vlogging. I decided I'm going to do weekly vlogging, and several of you guys gave me that idea to do a weekly vlog, because I just don't know if I'm up to the challenge of doing daily vlogging. I feel like I have it in my mind that you guys just probably get sick of me. You probably don't want to see me every day, especially when I upload a beauty video. And so, you know, I have my beauty videos, what I try to do a couple times a week, and then I have my my show on Beauty TV. So you're seeing me so many times a week, and I just figure, like, seeing this every day is just overkill. So I don't want to do daily vlogging. I don't want to bombard you with this. So I figured every Sunday I will upload a vlog and let you guys know what I've been up to during the week. And I just feel like I've grown so close to you, and I just don't want to. I got so connected. I saw, what is that word? Close? I don't know. You know what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to keep this as unedited as possible because I just want to really show you guys exactly what I'm feeling right now, or tell you guys what I'm feeling right now. So next, since today, well, today's Monday, so I figured I'll do it on Sundays, if that's what works for you. So let me know what you guys think. We'll try it out, and I'm just gonna miss you guys. Like, that's where it all comes down to, and yeah, I'm really gonna miss you guys. I really did enjoy Vlogust and, you know, talking to you guys and connecting with you guys every single day. I'm just really gonna miss you. So I think, you know, the once a week vlogging thing, I'll try it out, see how that goes, and we'll go from there. So I hope you guys have an amazing September. Thank you so much for making Vlogus so special and so amazing to me, or for me and for Brady, and I hope you guys had an amazing August as well. I will see you in the beauty videos. I'm not going anywhere. I'm still right here. And I just want you guys to know how special you are to me and how much I value our connection that we've made throughout this month. I'm not going anywhere. I will see you guys next Sunday. I will see you in the beauty videos. Just know that I'm thinking of you all the time. And just thank you. Okay. I'll let you go now. You've had too much of this all month long, so. Goodbye, and I'll see you next Sunday, as well as in the beauty videos. So thank you guys again.